I'm Dr. Melanie Windridge and I'm a plasma physicist. In fusion, we're trying to do something. You know, we're actually trying to make a new source of energy.
I love the outdoors, so I try and combine physics with the mountains or the Arctic or like any kind of outdoor adventure. I feel that a life in the outdoors gives you freedom. For me, it's not about the cities and about what we can do there, it's about what we can do out here.
This is the Solheimer Jökull Glacier. It's an outlet glacier that runs from the Mörderjökull ice cap. It's about 14 kilometres long, 1 to 2 kilometres wide, and it descends about 1,000 metres from the frozen ice cap to the warm, humid lowlands. The shape and location of the Solheimer Jökull Glacier make it particularly sensitive to climate change. You may think you know what causes the aurora, but you might be surprised. Most explanations miss out a key process, particle acceleration. Charged particles, electrons, are accelerated into our upper atmosphere in the polar regions. And here they hit into oxygen and nitrogen atoms and cause them to emit light. This is the aurora. So as soon as you start it up, it sings to you, it flashes all these lights everywhere. I think I'd probably lose my keys all the time if I had to just keep them there.
I much prefer not being in eco mode, I have to say.
What do you think are the major challenges now to getting you to beyond the hybrids?
The major challenges are the engine.
He actually stole Einstein's brain. He was really interested in finding out if there was a physical connection.
Really bubbling now. So we're at 5,200 metres and the water's boiling at 83.5 degrees.
We're back down from a grueling morning of walking. It was hell, actually.
It's snowing outside, it's still quite heavy, it's been snowing since last night. So we're camped up at the top of the ridge, there's quite an avalanche risk on the slope. So we just have to wait until the weather improves. I'm outside, it's been snowing a lot, we've been digging out the tents. Yeah, there's a lot of snow lying around.
Although the expedition itself wasn't successful in that we didn't reach the summit, it's still been a very interesting expedition, and there's been a lot of things going on, and I got to spend 2 days snowed in a tent on the top of a ridge. That was quite an interesting experience.
Really, we can do anything we want to do, and we shouldn't be held back.